Hi, in this video I'm going to show how to import Serial Studio into Torizon using VS Code. And the first thing we're going to do here is clone Serial Studio into our computer. And I'm doing this from the command line, from the integrated terminal. And as soon as it's finished, then we can use a command from the Torizon extension to import an existing C and C++ application. And then we head over to the directory, choose a few options that it will prompt for us, and we can select them. And this is the first step. Now we also need to make a few edits to the project file, and that's because we need the final binaries and resources installed into this QMake test dir. That is a variable set by the Torizon extension. As you can see, those are fairly easy to do. And once that's done, we also have to tell the Torizon extension the executable name, including the path, the relative path where it's installed. And we can try to run it, but it will fail because we have not added any dependencies, and it will not even compile because we don't have SDK dependencies or build time dependencies. We can edit the dev packages property to add those dependencies. As you can see in the video, I've added a few of them, and then we need to reload the extension and rebuild our SDK container, and we can try to run the project again. This time it will actually build the binaries and deploy them to the board or to the target. And it will even try to run it, but it will fail again as we have not yet added the runtime dependencies. And here we see libqt5charts is missing. So let's add it to the extra packages property. We try to run again, and we will find out that other runtime dependency is missing. And I will not do this for all of them, but you get the notion what you need to do. So I add all of the runtime dependencies, and now it will rebuild everything, deploy again to the target, and start the debug console. It will stop on the first line of the program, and we can continue and see on the screen hooked up to our embedded system that the application is running. But that is not all. We also need to allow the application to access the UART. Otherwise, it will not be able to function properly. As we add the UART on the build commands property, we rebuild the application, redeploy it, and it's ready to go.